He was a young man who disappeared from the world into tortured solitude. And for 15 years he hid, even from those closest to him. His name is Richard, and in March 2011, he traveled to a hospital in Baltimore looking for hope.
He had a baseball cap on and a surgical mask that covered this much of his face. And he looked up at me and he had these big, big brown eyes, and it just broke my heart.
For the woman charged with his care, Richard's story would become very personal.
In that moment, I saw in him the way his life has been.
Then a brilliant doctor devised a plan, but one so bold it had never been tried before.
You know, it's either going to be our proudest moment or our biggest failure.
And for Richard, getting a second chance would mean risking everything.
And I told Richard that you don't have to do this. You know, we love you just like you are.
But for one family to triumph, another family would have to endure a tragedy and make a courageous choice.
I would tell him that I would trade places with him in a moment, which I would have.
I thought, oh my God, what is this family being asked to do?
A special report, A Face in the Crowd.